Today we're going to talk about Microsoft To Do and how it integrates with other apps that you're using, like Outlook, Teams, and Planner. Now, for example, how can you easily create a task out of an email or create a calendar item out of a task? How about if a task is in Teams, how can you add it to To Do? So this whole integration was an important factor for me because I was only going to use yet another app if it fit properly in my world. We'll take a look at all of these, but if you're new to To Do, make sure you check out my other video that introduces you to the app and also shows you how you can properly organize your tasks. Once you're ready, join me here and we're going to talk about integration. To Do is currently well integrated with Outlook, especially Outlook on the web. Now you're going to be surprised here because Outlook on the web is more advanced to desktop. Now To Do is also well integrated with Teams. There are some new developments that are coming there, which I'm going to talk about. Let's jump in and talk about Outlook integration first. Let's start off with Outlook for desktop. So I have Outlook open right here. On the bottom, I can take a look at my to-dos. Any task that you see in your to-do list is either directly created in Outlook or in the To-Do app because everything is synced. You probably notice you have a more restricted view here. So you have your to-do list, you have your tasks, including completed tasks, and you have any lists that you might have created in To-Do. What you don't have are tasks that are assigned to you from Planner, for example. But what is important to know here is that any task you create or update in this view or in To-Do are going to be linked together. So for example, I'm just going to open my To-Do app and let's say I add a new task to my day. I should see that pop up in my To-Do list. Now we have to give it some time to sync, and when it does, it should pop up right here. And it was added right in the middle. Now notice that we don't have a separate My Day in here. Anything that doesn't have a date is going to be directly shown in this group. Now if I go here to Outlook and add a due date to this, so let's go with the 5th of March and let's save this, it should update in my To-Do app. And it updated right here. So it might take a few seconds to update, but ultimately they are connected with one another. Now, another thing I like to do is to create tasks out of emails. So for example, let's go back to email and let's say I want to create a task out of this email. I can just click on it and drag it to my tasks icon here and drop it there. Then I can assign a due date, add a reminder if I want, and add any other information I want to this. When I save this, I can see this task in my to-do list and my to-do app. So if I switch my view to here, that task is right here. And if I go to the app and switch to tasks, that task is right here. Now, the important thing to note here is that this task is now fully independent to the email. You can safely delete that email if you don't need to keep it in your inbox. If, on the other hand, you flag emails in your inbox, you'll directly see them under flagged email. So let's jump to Outlook. Let's go to inbox and I'm going to flag this. When I do that and I switch to my to-do, I should see it pop up here, and it does. When you click on this, you can directly open this in Outlook. Once you've completed this task and you place a check mark here, it's also going to remove the flag on the Outlook side. So if I bring up Outlook now, that flag is switched to completed. Now I'm just going to go ahead and clear this flag. So let's right mouse click and clear flag. Now here I need to mention that you can also add your to-dos to the sidebar here. So if you go to View under Layout, To-Do, Tasks, we get to see all our tasks on the side. But there is a difference when you drag and drop an email in this view. So if, for example, I take this email and I drag it and drop it in here, it doesn't create a separate task like it would if I drag and drop it in here. Instead, it flags the email. And in my To-Do app, this is going to show in the category flagged emails. Okay, so keep this in mind if you're using To Do on your sidebar. Remember how I told you that the web version of Outlook has more functionality and better integration than the desktop version? Well, let's take a look at that now. I'm going to bring up the browser and I'm already logged into my office.com account. Let's go and open Outlook. Now, just like we have in the desktop version, we also have To Do in the web version. But take a look at this. When I switch my view to To Do, I actually see what I see in the app. I have my day, I have tasks that are assigned to me. Everything is visible here. And when I'm in To Do, I can easily switch to my email by clicking on this envelope. Now, don't worry, you don't have to keep clicking around because you can also see your to-dos directly in this view. There is a feature up here called My Day. When you select that, you have your to-dos here. You can easily add a new task. You can also click on an email and drag it and add it as a task. Just rename it. Right mouse click and add in other information. So for example, set a reminder, set a due date, and so on. Now, in addition to to-dos here, you can switch to calendar view. This gives you a preview of your tasks organized by due date. Because you have a separate to-do bar here, it's also really easy to add to-dos to your calendar. So if I bring up the calendar here and go back to my day here, I have my to-dos, and let's say I want to free up some time to do the slides for the steering committee, I can click on this and then drag it into my calendar. A new event is created. When I open this up, I can edit it, invite attendees if I want to work on this with other people, and I can set a specific time to get this task done. Once you're done, save it. Now, another advantage you have with To Do here is that whenever you drag an email and add it to To Do, you can directly click on the mail icon here and it takes you to that email. This functionality currently works for flagged emails on desktop, but it doesn't work for emails that you create a task out of. Okay, so that sums up our Outlook for the web integration. Now, let's take a look at integration of To Do with Teams. Now, I'm logged into Microsoft Teams, and if you spend a lot of time in here, you probably want to have your to-dos and any tasks assigned to you in Planner all in one place. You can add the Tasks tab to the sidebar. Go to More Options and add Tasks by Planner and To-Do. Now, if you don't see it here, just type in Tasks, it's going to pop up, and select it. If you want this to stick to your sidebar so that every time you click away, it doesn't disappear, right mouse click and pin it. Now, notice we see our to-dos here. We can easily add a task in this view. We can update and manage our tasks, and we get to see all tasks that are in Planner, which are assigned to us. So we have the same options we have in Planner. I'm looking at list view here, but I can easily switch to board view and manage my cards and my buckets from this view as well. Now, another really cool and handy option that's coming soon is the ability to automatically create a task from a message. Now, this can be a conversation in Teams or it can be a conversation in chat. All you would need to do in the future is click on More Options, go to More Actions, and select Create Task. Now, we don't see it right now because it's not rolled out yet, but it was announced by Microsoft and it should be coming soon. Once you add it as a task, you're going to see it in the task pane right here. And finally, let's take a look at the integration of Planner and To Do. So I'm back in the To Do app, and I want to see tasks that have been assigned to me from Planner. I can switch my view to Assign to You. I get a complete list of these tasks, and when I select one, so for example this one, I can even see the steps and the checklist that was created in Planner. Now, if you scroll down, it says some options aren't available for this task, but you can open this in Teams. So notice it's not open in Planner, it's open in Teams. When you click that, let's open the desktop version, it takes me directly to Tasks by Planner, and it opens that Planner task. I can create new items here or create these from my to-do. Now, whenever you mark a task as completed, so let's say I'm back in my to-do here and I mark this one as completed, it's going to mark it as completed in Planner as well. So we can see it if I switch to the Teams app, Task My Planner, go to General Tasks. It's not here anymore. I'm going to go to Board, Show Completed, and that's the task I just checked off. Okay, so that's how the To-Do app is integrated with the other apps that you might be using. Remember, you have access to all of these different tasks to create the task that you need to concentrate on today. So go to More Suggestions here, find your tasks, and just add them to your today's list. You can also directly go to a task and drag and drop it to My Day, or just right mouse click and add it to your day. As you can see with To-Do, you make sure that you stay on top of tasks, and you also have a central place for managing all of your tasks. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did and you learned something new, please be kind to give this video a thumbs up. Also check to see if you're subscribed, because if you aren't, consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.